channel. This is Beth from Style at a Certain Age, and I just returned back to Athens. Mr. Style and I actually hopped in the car yesterday, and we zipped down to Atlanta to pay a visit to the Nordstrom store there. As we know, the Nordstrom sale is in full swing, and so I wanted just to pay a visit and just kind of knock around and see which items I really, really liked in person, and then which ones I actually could come home with and which ones I had to place an order for. But I was lucky enough to score two items that were on my must-have list for my first round draft picks. If you didn't read that blog post, I sent that out on Thursday. I was hoping to actually have a video on Thursday as well, but time just got away from me. But I had my first round draft picks from Nordstrom, the end sale, and so I brought home two. Yay! That were in stock. One is this beautiful cashmere turtleneck. This is from the Vince collection. And then I also brought home this really cool, iconic bomber jacket. It's in black, the bomber jacket or the bombardier jacket. So stay tuned to the very end. So I'm showing you three different ways that you can wear this iconic classic. One way is going off to work. One is date night. And then the third one is weekend wear. And I always like to, whenever I add anything into my closet, I want to make sure that I can use it and wear it in more than one way. And because the more versatility that an item has, the more bang for your buck that you get. So stay tuned to the end of the video for that. And also, I shared last week that I'm offering a $250 gift certificate for one lucky reader. And all you have to be eligible for that is just subscribe to the channel. You're entered into the pool because the winner is going to be picked from just the YouTube subscribers. So if you want a $250 gift certificate from Nordstrom, just subscribe to the channel and I will announce the winner on July 31st. Okay? All right. It's very interesting to delve into a little bit of history. And so I'm going to share a few fun facts about this very iconic classic that's made it into my must-have as far as classic items, timeless item that will stand the test of time. So originally the bomber jacket, so there's kind of been an evolution. So it started off as the military flight jacket, and that was created way back in 1915 or thereabouts in World War I. And that was the Royal Flying Corps of Belgium and France created the first military jacket, and it was made out of leather, the most durable material at that time, and it was fashioned after another very iconic military invention, and that was the trench coat. So it looked very much like the trench coat that Burberry is famous for, has lasted all these years. So the first military jacket was double-breasted, knee-length, and then it had the belt, was lined with fur to keep the military personnel warm. And the big difference between modern aviation and that of a century ago is that when aviation first started out, the cockpits were not enclosed. So a little bit breezy up there, and they were flying at very high altitude, so it's also very chilly when you do that. And I grew up watching the movies. I think there was a very famous one that I can't remember the name of it, but it was about the Red Baron. So the Flying Aces of World War I, and then Snoopy came along and kind of had their little spin on it. So you saw Snoopy, you know, with the goggles and then the scarf on, and then the leather coat, and that was to keep the military personnel warm. So that was the first time that we saw it was during World War I. And I will just mention too, it's always kind of interesting between, you know, how form and function then meets high fashion at a certain point. And I also find it very interesting that many of our very iconic items come straight from the military. And that is, as I mentioned, the trench coat that Burberry, or many say the Burberry invented it, you know, for World War I, and the military officers wore that. The pea coat that the naval sailors wore to keep them warm on the very cold bridges of the ships. Or, and I talked about this last week, the Breton striped tee that was also created for the Navy sailors, so when they fell overboard, they could be easily spotted. So there's always a reason, there's always that, you know, that very functional aspect of a garment before high fashion takes it and then kind of puts it into pop culture. So, but back to the bomber jacket. So we first saw that in World War I with our military personnel. Then the next evolution that it had was in 1932 because the U.S. military took note of how it was crafted for World War I. And in 1932, they came up with, I believe it was the A2 leather bomber jacket. So what they did is they shortened up the jacket and they put wool ribbing around the waist and then and the wrists. So it became, because the cockpits were very, very tight, so they had to be able to maneuver a little bit, but they still had to be kept very warm. So the material again was leather, very durable. It was still lined, but this time, so they did away with the fur and they adopted the lamb shearling or the lamb's wool. And that's still a very iconic jacket that you still see today. So that jumped up. 1932, and our military personnel wore that all through World War II, and so you see 1950 it was. So that's when the Air Force brought in the first nylon jacket, and so that was because they needed the cockpits had changed, now they're enclosed, and it was crammed full of gear. So, and they also wanted a jacket that they could wear all year round, not just in certain times of the year. So the first nylon jacket then is pushed into popularity, and that was about 1950. So and I forgot to mention, so the bomber jacket, so it has two pockets in front. You'll typically always see that, and that was, many people think that was because so the military could, you know, have a place to put their hands. That was really just to store all the gear that they needed. Their glasses and whatever else they were, you know, carrying into the cockpit. So that they always have the slanted pockets. But in 1950, when the nylon jacket came along, the Air Force added a pocket on the side. So you'll see a lot of jackets will have the zippered pocket on the sleeve, and that's why. So 1950, nylon jackets, you can wear it year-round, very lightweight, because there again, I mentioned the cockpits now have all these gadgets, and it's just kind of crammed full of this, that, and the other thing. So, but then we're fighting about 1952, then the Korean War comes into being, and then on into the 60s with the Vietnam War. So then that's when you start to see the color change because of the jungles that the aircraft was flying over. So in case the pilot had to eject or the plane crashed, they were wearing a jacket that would kind of blend into the background. So then that's when the green nylon jacket really became very, very popular, and then the camouflage as well. And you'll see those out and about. I think I have one of each. I think I do. And I love to wear them. Really, really fun. So that's really just the kind of evolution that we've seen. The bombardier jacket that came from the military flight jacket, and then we shortened it down to bomber jacket. And then, how did pop culture get a hold of it? And then how did high fashion also decide to, you know, put it on for street style and streetwear? Well, we have two movies really to thank for that. And I think it's always interesting what an impact movies and fashion in movies have on our society. So way back in the 60s, and actually it was my dad's favorite actor, and that was Steve McQueen. And he starred in a movie called The Hunter, and he depicted a bounty hunter in that movie. And all throughout the movie, he sported a green nylon jacket. So that immediately just soared into popularity. And I remember my dad, he always had a bomber jacket. He loved them. Or baseball, a lot of people call them baseball jackets too. So he always had, you know, one version or another. And his last version that he had was a leather bomber jacket, and it had a zip-out lining. It's fur, and actually I still have that. That's I have two things of his Burberry trench jacket, which is actually way too big for me, but I'm loath to give up, and then the vest that was part of his bomber jacket. So, and I'll wear that as a vest too. So, but my dad loves Steve McQueen, and Steve was really, actually he was pretty cool actor, and he always, you know, kind of played these badasses. So Steve McQueen and his role in The Hunter was the first kind of thrust into pop culture. And then there was another movie in, I think it was 1985, 1986, and many of you will remember this. So this is Top Gun and Tom Cruise, and it was such a great movie. It was an immediate hit, and that's really when it just, you know, Tom Cruise just soared into, you know, superstardom. So he was a hotshot Navy pilot, and he had, again, the green nylon jacket. But his, you'll see, it's a little bit different. So he had all these different patches that were sewn on. And so if you ever see jackets that have that, that's, you know, kind of where, and I think actually that harkens back to World War II, where the actual pilots would, like, you know, put things from their squadron or, you know, whatever they wanted to sew on. You kind of saw that back then. So two movies just, you know, popped it into the jackets that we see today, and high fashion then adopted that, and now you see lots of different versions. And again, so I'm going to show you three different ways of the black one that I bought from the Vince collection from the Nordstrom sale. So if you're ready to take a look, we're going to see three different ways that you can wear this iconic,
and the first outfit is headed straight into the work week.
Are you ready?
Okay. I have the bomber jacket paired over a Ponte pencil skirt, but the fun comes with this belt with the gold grommet details. Keeps it very fresh and very, very modern. But the black pointy toe pumps and the black structured handbag keep it conservative and office appropriate. And there again, we have a classic color combo, black and white. You can never go wrong with that. Okay, we're going from the work week straight into date night, and I've paired the bomber jacket over a tuxedo shirt. It's striped, and that is, again, topped over cigarette pants. So I have the long over lean and then the short bomber jacket. So you have three different elements going on, three different lengths, and a clutch handbag, metal hardware, and block heels with a little bit of pearl embellishment. The last outfit, last but not least, head straight into our weekend, ladies, and I have the gorgeous Vince turtleneck, striped turtleneck, cashmere. Will serve me well all winter long, but so the bomber jacket, black skinny jeans, turtleneck, although I've kept the item very fresh and very modern, again, with the accessories. The hobo bag with the gold hardware, suede mules or slides, and a very, very classic belt. So you see three different ways that you can wear one iconic, classic, timeless item. I love having this bomber jacket in my closet. And I will see you next week, ladies. Thanks for tuning in.